Woo!
Yeah. Okay.
Oh, that was dope.
What is up, Not So Pro Football Talk? This is another episode of Not So Pro Seahawks Talk. And as you saw right before this, we're going to jump right in like DK Metcalf jumped to catch that ball. So we got a lot of stuff to unpack today. It's going to be one of the last videos of this month because we're going to start moving into doing off-season content for the NFL in its entirety. So I'll be back with another Not So Pro Seahawks Talk video probably next month when there's more drama, more contract negotiations, as well as draft prospects that I think the Seahawks can get. But for right now, let's go ahead and get to this topic. So as we saw before this video started, DK Metcalf jumped into the stratosphere without even bending his knees fully. So it was pretty crazy to see that right before the NBA celebrity All-Star game. So it was pretty crazy. Just showed off those hops like he did in the game when he was playing for that celebrity team. I think he was on the West team, but I think they had different names than that. So it was pretty cool to see that. But the funny thing is that night he got a text message from one of the NFL drug testing agencies saying that he had a randomized drug test in two days' time after that. So just a funny coincidence. DK is not on any PEDs. He is a straight shooter. He's just a freak athlete, just like any other player in the NFL. So that's a pretty fun topic. But getting into more topics here. So we have a lot to unpack here. It looks like there's going to be a lot more going on in the coaching carousel. As we can see so far we have our wide receivers coach, our QB's coach, and Dave Canales. And now we have our defensive line / defensive end coach leaving as well. He's not going with Dave Canales to the Buccaneers, but he's going to the Steelers, and he's going to become the linebackers coach over there. So, I mean, he's going to have a good group over there. Steelers are a rising team, in my opinion. They're not to the defensive standards that they used to be, but I think they will get some good players in the draft as well as the guys that they're developing. So kudos to him. His name is Aaron Curry, so I hope he does well over there in Pittsburgh. But moving on to some more coaching opportunities for the Seahawks, we have a possible QB coach coming into Seattle, and his name is Greg Olsen. But it's not the Greg Olsen you're thinking about. It's not the tight end who used to play for Carolina, who jumped around and also played for the Seahawks for a little bit. It's not him. It's going to be Greg Olsen with two O's in his last name. He is an outstanding coach. He developed a lot of players in college, as well as a little bit in the NFL. People like John Kitna, Drew Brees, Jared Goff, and a guy who plays in one of the divisional teams that we have. His name was Jeff Garcia. I mean, he did all right, but we won't praise him. He's a 49ers player. But anyways, moving on. We have some great coaches that are probably going to become coaches here for the Seattle Seahawks. So it's going to be super exciting to see what develops as the offseason goes along. So keep tuned and let's go to the next topic. So just like the coaching carousel goes and we're going to be hiring new coaches, we are extending some players who are vital to our success. And I talked about one of those guys and his name is Nick Bellore. Talked about his podcast In Between Two Bellores, so that will be continuing for the Seahawks fans. For you 12s that know of that podcast, it's pretty funny. Super short clips where he does it inside of Lumen Field, and he just invites random players from the Seahawks organization or coaching staff, and he interviews them. It's super funny, super interesting. So I'm glad that Nick Bellore is back with us for a two-year extension. So he's going to be a Seahawk for the next two seasons, and he's going to help us out there on kickoffs, punt returns, as well as playing linebacker whenever he needs to. Great resource in him, so I'm super glad that he is back. Other guy is Phil Haynes. He is one of our offensive linemen, but we may look to move him around as we probably make some more draft picks in this draft to address the offensive line. So you can only get better as every season goes along, so we're looking to add some more depth to our offensive line just in case injuries happen. You know, we can't re-sign all the guys we need to, or just to help us get on friendlier contracts as the seasons go along and people want to get paid. Unfortunately for Phil Haynes, this extension is only a one-year extension, so keep that in mind for you Seahawks fans who are keeping track of how long we're going to have certain players. But it looks like Phil Haynes will only be a temporary fix for us until we, like I said, we can get more players in the draft. So keep that in mind, as well as keep a track on those other players that the Seahawks may extend, or if they may pick up some guys in free agency. So there are a lot of guys in free agency. We'll talk about that in another video, as well as along the season with me, AJ, and Reed, giving you video content every week. Lastly, some stuff that happened about a week and a half ago that I did not touch in the last video. There is a lot of movement in the front office for the Seattle Seahawks. It's going to be very interesting to see how this shakes out and who fills in the spots, but let's get right into it. So, first off, Noah Teasley. He's been promoted to the assistant general manager position right below John Schneider. So that is very interesting because he was the team directors of pro personnel. So I don't know what that is, but obviously he deals with a lot of personnel on the football team, in the front office. So he's got a lot of tools in his tool belt to help us out as our assistant GM. So should be interesting. Next guy I want to talk about is Matt Berry. He's been promoted to senior director of pro personnel, which was Nolan Teasley's position. But now he leaves a vacant spot in the team's director of college scouting. So as the season, or as the offseason comes about and we're getting almost ready to draft with our 9 picks in the draft, we have a vacant position for the director of college scouting. So hopefully he's done all the scouting that he needs to do up until this point. I'm pretty sure everybody else will pick up the slack, and I'm sure we're going to draft some crazy, crazy good talent this year, just like we did last year. So keep that in mind. There's a lot of positions in the front office that need to be filled for the Seattle Seahawks this offseason. It's going to be interesting, and so is the draft. So that is all I have for you guys today. Make sure you leave a like. Make sure you leave a comment. Make sure you check out the upcoming content that we have coming out here on NSP Football Talk. It's going to be great. Also, don't forget that we are having a sponsor named Redcon One. So check out some of our videos. Redcon One is there. Use our code. It is T20NSP. I'll repeat that again, T20NSP. And that's for all Redcon One products, whether you're going to use energy drinks, whether you're going to use pre-workout, whether you just need something to get you through the day. If you guys need any help with seeing what you should use or what you might want to try, go ahead and hit us up and we'll give you the best options for your daily routine. Other than that, guys, that's all I have for you today. Go Seahawks, go 12s. I'll be back in a month. But other than that, guys, see you next video. Go 12s.